Tongue-tied like we never know. Telling those stories we've already told. Cause we don't say what we really mean. We've long been waiting for an official single to follow Don't Go Yet. Not only did we get the official single, we got the album announcement. April 8th, Familia will be out, and I will 100% certainly be reacting to that album on this channel with all you guys, because if you've seen any of my Camila Cabello reactions, you know that I think the world of her as both an artist, musician, but most importantly as a human being. So that leads me to be incredibly excited about this song here, and it's featuring Ed Sheeran. I didn't expect that. Ed Sheeran, this is Bomb Bomb. I did enjoy the South of the Border collaboration that they had together. It'll be nice to have it be on Camila's side this time and kind of see what she does with this and just get a much broader and more specific idea of what this album is going to sound like. All right, guys, let's listen to this song. I'm so excited for this. It's not even funny. Just the fact that Ed Sheeran collaboration and just she's really doing it. I'm so proud of her. And also, I've avoided every single clip, like, just I have no idea what this even sounds like. So, it'd be like that. It'd be like that. 1,000%.
Said you hated the ocean, but you're surfing now. I said I love you for life, but I just sold our house. You said you hated the ocean, but you're surfing now. I said I love you for life, but I just sold our house. You said you hated the ocean, but you're surfing now. I said I love you for life, but I just sold our house.
Wow. Because I know exactly what that's about. Both of those lines. You said you hated the ocean, but you're surfing now. I sold our house. Oh my goodness. So that is for you got, I love specific lyricism. That's what that is. But that's heartbreaking because I know what it's about. And the fact that she can, like, share that with everyone, you know what I mean? Share that with the fans. Actually put those lyrics in a song so soon, by the way. Like, you know, everyone has different healing times and processes you know, to be able to at this point anyway, share this with all of us and her fans and put this out there, to me, I feel like is a big deal and says a lot about her as an artist once again and as a human who's processing and healing. And also the fact that this opens up the way it does. She's clearly been crying. She's eating ice cream. She's drinking. She's just fucking like she's feeling everything you can feel in a negative way. Just like going through it, I should say. She's going through it. And then that's the line that opens the song and follows that little scene. I think that just says all you need to know, just as far as like feelings are real, experiences are real, and we all go through it. And I think that that's okay. And I'm glad I paused here because now I'm seeing this Life is Beautiful thing right here. Wait, no, isn't that a song by her? Is she throwing Easter eggs into this video now?
We were kids at the start, I guess we're grown-ups now.
Oh my god, Camila's just humming for me lyrically.
You couldn't ever imagine even having doubts, but not everything works out, no. Now I'm out dancing with strangers, you could be casually dating. Damn, it's all changing so fast. I see it loving, I see it. Yeah, that's just life, baby.
Oh my god, what?
Yeah, love came around and it knocked me down, but I'm back on my feet. I see it loving, I see it. Yeah, that's just life, baby.
This is fucking great. is that ba bum bum ba. That's about to be the hook. Smart.
His arm, baby.
I was barely standing, now I'm dancing, he's all over me. Just talking about how fast things happen, how fast things change. If she's gonna dance in there. So this right here, she was drinking in the beginning. Now she's dancing in it, in the liquor and the alcohol. And that's just her like embracing all of it. And I love that that thing said life is beautiful in the beginning, because literally like at the end of the day, you go through what you're going to go through. Think you're going to be sad. You're going to go through breakups. You're going to go through ups and downs. You're going to have your heart broken. You know, you're going to hurt people's feelings. All these things are going to happen. But you just, you got to, like, these things are going to happen fast, too. And you just got to, like, embrace the good parts of life and learn to live and love through it all and stay who you are and remain a gracious person, a gracious human being. And that's exactly what all this says to me. Her dancing in the wine, it's exactly what that says to me. If it's wine, I hope it's wine, because anything stronger, you could get yourself in deeper shit.
It's been a hell of a year, thank God we made it.
I love that. I just love the chorus. I love that chorus. And I love that there's so many lyrics that lead up to the chorus that opens up the chorus lyrically. Choruses aren't lyrical usually. But I like that in that, like, because there's so many lyrics that lead up to that chorus, it kind of opens up what the meaning of that chorus is. And again, we're being served here. That's what we're doing.
It's been a hell of a year, thank God we made it out. Yeah, we were riding away and trying not to drown. And on the surface, I held it together, but underneath, the sort of came unwound. Where would I be? You're all that I need, my world. You always hold me down. Well, I've been the breaker and broke. Always hold me down. I've been the breaker and broken. Every mistake turns to moments. Wouldn't take anything back. I see a hell of a
lot. Okay, here's a, okay. He's got the bruised eye, and he's just smiling and living life through it, understanding that through the pain, you just gotta keep living. Understand that life is beautiful. And then he flashes back to her in front of the gas station, the bodega, the convenience store, wherever she's at. Again, also sort of smiling through the pain.
You always hold me down.
Love this
man. I've been the breaker and broken. Every mistake turns to moments. Wouldn't take anything back. I still love you.
She's gonna keep getting hurt. Nothing, she understands that, and she's just gonna live through it all and smile through it all and embrace life. And I love that visually. I love the meaning of all that. And what I also love is that, you know, watching this music video and all that's being explained to me visually, even if I wasn't watching the video, I would be able to understand that through the lyrics. I love when both those things work at the same time. Keep dancing through it all. And I love the back and forth, the Spanish to English. You know how long that note was?
Yeah.
Okay, now we're talking. Even these alley shots are gorgeous. I love the laundromat. I love this shot as well. So this song is, I know Ed Sheeran's on the song, right? So yeah, you do have that pop touch, but this song is all the way salsa, all the way, and more, even more so than Don't Go Yet. And I actually, you know, Don't Go Yet, I love Don't Go Yet, right? The music video to me is just, that music video remains on a whole other level. Like, my goodness, visually speaking, and then just everything it represents as well. But I like this song better than Don't Go Yet. And for her to transition from self-titled and Romance, which are like, yeah, she's got like Latin infusion in there, but for the most part those are pop and R&B infused albums. For her to just make the leap into this sound and make it seamlessly, actually make it organically, actually have it sound great, this is a great song, and I'm so proud of her again as an artist, and it fills me with so much joy for it to actually be as good as it is, you know, because these are risks. There's risks involved with jumping from a world where you have so much success, right? Like, she did so well, like Havana, Senorita, all these songs that she's got that just have billions of streams, and then you jump into a completely different world. This is a different world. It's a risk. And the only reason you make that risk is because you actually jump in it for the love of it. She loves this. That's why she's doing this. The album's named Familia. All of this is love inspired. It's every single bit of it. And I love this song. I just love the coming back from pain and knowing you're going to get knocked down. Just keep on dancing, get back up, and it's going to happen fast. And everything about this, guys, I cannot emphasize enough how much I love this song. Camila Cabello is one of the best artists we've got right now, and I hope you all appreciate that. And I can't wait for the album, and I hope you all, you know, join me for that. For anyone that might have missed it, I interviewed Kay Cannon, who was the director of Cinderella, that was starring Camila Cabello, of course. And we talked about Camila quite a bit, and all we do is just glow about her as a person and human, because that's all you really can do when it comes to her. Five Sauce, complete mess. My goodness, is there not a single Five Sauce fan alive who's just not, has not been anticipating this song to the maximum degree for a while now, and we finally got it. And of course they did all their sneaky, cheeky stuff in the process of delivering it to us, but it's finally here. I want to say that I, between 2011 and I reacted to on my Patreon their show, the Five Sauce 10 year anniversary show, and between both of those things, I truly have no clue what direction they're headed in with what this is going to sound like, what the album's going to sound like. With a lot of the mixes that they had on the 5-year celebration show, and a lot of like the older songs they were performing, and the way they sort of changed some of the dynamics to those songs, I no idea, but I'm so here for it, because we know that this group, you know, between what we got from Youngblood to Calm, Sounds Good, Feels Good, and then from even like One Face and Things We Turn Away From and Super Bloom, you know, I factor those projects in just as far as like this group, these four artists, I feel like have gone through quite the transition musically. And, you know, you hear about a lot of the stuff they talk about, and they never were writing just to write. They only write songs when they really feel like they've got something to share, got something to give, got something good to make. And I love and appreciate that so much, and I feel like that's going to lead to just a really special project. And I didn't think it could get more special than Calm, but I really, truly feel like it's going to happen. So let's check out Complete Mess. This sounds, what does this sound like? Oh, I can't, it's too at the top of my head for me not to reference it. This sounds exactly like It's No Shame. Right? It's just more mellow. And even the subtitles you have, soft music, birds chirping. Oh my gosh. I want to just start screaming No Shame.
Caught up in heaven, but your heaven ain't the same. And I've never been a saint, have I?
What the fuck?
But I never want to change your
mind. What kind of lyrics are these?
Seven essence always fleeting like a flame. But I never want to change your mind. Call it a lesson when I feel you slide away. And I'm missing out on half my life.
Okay, so very much calling this person half of their life, which is a very, like, openly romantic way to say that. My goodness. The lyrics to this song so far are profound. Oh, my goodness. I don't even know what to say about that. There's so much.
Oh, you make me complete.
Irony of that is they do that to a lot of their fans. This is unlike anything I've heard from them. There's so many aspects to that. Like there's this spacey feeling to this that I haven't heard from them before. There's this there's this reflective feeling I haven't heard from them before. Like, Calm had some of this, just as far as looking back and having these deep interpersonal conflicts and thoughts to yourself. But, like, when you incorporate that into the sound of this already, it's just, like, a whole different level of music from them and lyricism from them. That, again, this is a different level for them.
Hang on to moments like they'll never drift away. Cause you'll never get to say goodbye. I ask no questions as your colors take their hold. As my darkness turns to gold inside.
Even like every single lyric is stabbing at me. I've every single one. And that, yeah, like Girl Cried Wolf, Ghost of You, it's that's happened to me before. Yes, best years, but like not every single fucking word in the song.
Cause you'll never get to say goodbye.
What was that colors scheme?
I ask no questions as your colors take their hold. As my darkness turns to gold inside.
Wow, you just made me a better person. I was black inside and you had all these multiple colors and your colors took over me and turned me into gold. What the fuck is happening in this song?
I learned my lesson when I felt you slip away. And I'm missing out on
my life. and stripping all that away and coming back with it is so effective. Right after here. Think about this song live. That guitar climbs up your spine.
Caught up in heaven, but your heaven ain't the same. But I've never been a saint, have I?
I love the dished out vocals. Like, everyone's sort of getting a prime opportunity to come in with these very impactful. Again, these lyrics are so impactful. So when you have all of the group kind of getting their moment lyrically in the song, it works that much better. And Michael's got the most unique voice out of all of them, so giving him the bridge makes so much sense in the world. And he even like had a different tone there than he typically has when I hear him sing. This is incredible, guys. This is incredible. How do I go from 2011 to complete mess, still have absolutely no clue in this world what direction the album's going into? And I think that's okay. I think that's almost the point. You know, I think it's almost like we're just gonna make shit that we think sounds great and that resonates with us. These are two completely different songs, and they both work so well in their own way. This is a different level. This is a different level than 2011. 2011 was the perfect song to come back with because of what it represented, obviously, in the 10 year. This song here is maybe the best song I've ever heard from Five Sauce. And that's saying a lot because when I did my end of 2020 list, I had a couple of Five Sauce songs off of Calm. And what I thought were the best songs of the year that year. And there's, you know, Ghost of You remains one of the best songs I've ever heard from an artist, group artist, period. So for me to really sit here and really do feel like this might be their best moment, song-wise, is a big deal. And wow, the album. What is the album going to sound like? What's going to be on there? There's going to be more lyrics like this? Because if there is, sign me all the way up for that album and for that breakdown and for just all the lyrics I get hit with in that, because my darkness, you have all these colors and it takes a hold of my darkness, turns to gold, and then everything, like Luke's first verse and then going into Callum's verse, and just there were some vocals from Ashton there at the end. I'm pretty sure that was him when it was really starting to get big vocally and bigger, the song got bigger and bigger, and Michael on the bridge was the perfect choice again, even singing in a different style than I normally hear from him, more like open and higher toned style. And I don't know what else to say that I haven't said, because this is incredible. What a time for music. Joshua Bassett, Doppelganger. Now, I don't know what his intention is, speaking of Joshua here, just as far as if he's just dropping us, blessing us with songs, blessing us with singles here and there, the sort of trio of songs that came out prior in Crisis, Set Me Free, Secrets, where I had two of those songs, Crisis and Set Me Free, as two of the best songs that came out in 2021. And I continue to feel that way, even stronger in my stance as time goes on. So for him to just give us more Doppelganger, and no idea if this is going to lead. One thing I know about Joshua is he doesn't have a full-length album, right? So are we leading up to that? I'm not sure. I certainly hope so, selfishly, obviously, because Joshua has been the definition of getting better, of just everything he does gets better and better and better and better. And there's still a couple things I haven't even heard from him. There's a couple songs I know he's dropped in between his EP and the trio of songs he released recently that I know I haven't heard. But just taking what I've heard chronologically speaking and going through all of it and just seeing how much better he's gotten is the goal as an artist. And you guys know how I feel about him. You know how my favorite thing about Joshua is how he wears his heart on his sleeve, how he's so honest and forthright, and he's just out in the open. He just leaves himself out there. He's such a vulnerable human being, and I absolutely love and adore that about him. I mean, I think we need more men like that, you know, more artists and people like that, but particularly more men like that. Just stop pretending, or just stop, not pretending, but, you know, stop closing yourself up. You don't have to be like that. It's not necessary. And it's a lot more healthy to come to the other side and let it out. And just put yourself out there. And you surround yourself with love and people that actually care about you and really give a shit about you. I promise beautiful things will happen inside your soul. And Joshua, to me, represents that wonderfully. And he's so young, you know, to see him actually, you know, carry all those values and live his life that way at such a young age, particularly, obviously, after all the stuff he went through, makes me admire that much more, because when I was that age, I couldn't have never in a million years wrapped my mind around living life that way. I wish I did, because the earlier you start that, the longer you get to feel that wonderful feeling. So let's jump into Doppelganger, guys. I have no idea what the song's going to be about, but again, Joshua giving us new music is always a treat. Now, a doppelganger is someone that looks like someone else, or like, if you, like, you're like, oh, this is your doppelganger, aka this person looks just like you. Like, that's a general definition, as far as I've always understood. So is that girl the doppelganger? He's like, and let's not forget, Joshua's an actor, so he's already wearing it on his face. Yeah, I'm watching this, and my first thing that pops in my head is like, oh, we're watching a movie, we're watching a TV show, because I already am being sold by Joshua, the actual actor, that he just bumped into somebody, saw somebody that's a doppelganger of a former lover, because then we cut into those little flash scenes of, like, where he was with someone, and it seems like all these feelings probably just rush back into him.
I guess I'm not as over you as I thought that I was.
It all just hit him.
I saw someone who looked like you at our favorite coffee shop, and part of me was hoping we would get the chance to talk. I guess I'm not as over you as I thought.
Again, when I opened up this video and I talked about his honesty and putting himself out there, those lyrics say all that right there.
And a lot of nights, memorizing lines, thinking about what I might say. And after all this time, I'm still fight or flight. I can't help but run away. And after all this time, I'm still fight or flight. I can't help but run away.
After all this time, I'm still fight or flight. And that reminds, that's a Conan Gray song, right? And I love that song, by the way. I can't help but not think about that song when I hear that one.
Nights, memorizing lines, thinking about what I might say. And after all this time, I'm still fight or flight. I can't help but run away. I know we're getting older, we're moving on and over, but everywhere I go, I see your face. I guess I'm not as over you as I thought that I was. I saw someone who looked like you at our favorite coffee shop, and part of me was hoping we would get the chance to talk. I guess I'm not as over you as I thought, and I thought I was.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, what is that?
I was. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
That's such a nice, like, change and surprise in the song. I didn't expect that. It doesn't really. It's not. It's, he's completely abandoning structure by
doing. I thought I was. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Love that.
Yeah, I thought I was. Your yellow dress, same as when we met. I couldn't believe my eyes.
I was still a wreck, trying to find the reason why. She wore your yellow dress, same as when we met. I couldn't believe my eyes. Even when I left, I was still a wreck, trying to find the reason why. I'm scared to death to see ya, but I wanted it to be ya. And worst of all, I don't even know why.
Man, okay, so I love this song, and I love the song more and more as it goes, because it's slowly unpacking more and more lyrically, and I appreciate Joshua's songwriting so much. I'm scared to death to see her. I wanted it to be her, and I don't know why. And you go back to that first verse when he was talking about, he was like rehearsing his lines. He's fight or flight. Like, literally, he would rehearse thoughts in his own head before, like, if the off chance happened where he'd run into her, like, or if he knew he was gonna run into her, he literally would have lines rehearsed before he would go see her. That's when you know, like, things are, you're really feeling all types of things, and there's a lot of anxiety within you about all of this, and obviously there's pain involved, because he probably, I don't even know, did he want this to end? Because obviously there's still feelings involved. He's not over her. If he was, he wouldn't have all this happened. Just running into a doppelganger at a coffee shop is causing all these feelings and emotions. And for him to say here, like, I wanted it to be here, like, I was actually hoping anyone that's been through a breakup, you literally, it's a fucking night. If you've been through a breakup with someone that you don't have feelings for anymore, that you don't want to be with anymore, you know, that you're good with that part of your life, you're past, like, you don't want to revisit that, it's a fucking nightmare, the thought of running into them, right? Like, it's like, you see the coffee shop, you bump into them, and it's like, it actually could be them. You do everything you can to get out of there, or pretend at all costs that you did not see them, or hide behind a bush, or whatever you can do, you know, act crazy, scream, and pretend to be an insane person that just, like, cannot be in a conversation. But no, he's like, I was kind of hoping it was there, because obviously there's still something there for on his end. And he's reliving, like, when he first met her, and the dress she was wearing when he first met her, the details, like, the things that he can actually call back on and remember, because those are the feelings that live within him still for this person. And again, that's why I appreciate these lyrics at this point, because they're calling back on lyrics earlier on. Like, it all is a story being told, and it makes sense. Also, that's, you know, I know who he's talking about, because of some specificities that are part of this video that I'm not even going to get into. But can we just talk about the honesty and how just willing he is to just be that honest and vulnerable within his music? Think about that.
I guess I'm not as over you as I thought that I was. I saw someone who looked like you at our favorite coffee shop. And part of me was hoping we would get the chance to talk. I guess I'm not as over you as I thought. And I thought I was. Your place.
A lookalike can never take the heart cannot be lied to. A lookalike can never take your place. The song is called Doppelganger. Come on, Joshua.
I guess I'm not as over you as I thought that I was.
And then you look at this scene here in the video, and he walking up to her with this look of like he's seeing a ghost. And he's the cut away to them dancing, like, that's the most, out of all those scenes, that's the most connected and romantic, probably, and that's the scene you go to. It's because that's what he's reliving in this moment. That's probably what he wants to go relive here.
I saw someone who looked like you at our favorite coffee shop. Part of me was hoping, favorite.
This doesn't happen, though. This right here.
Coffee shop.
This, well, you know, actually, maybe if it's Joshua Bassett looking over at you all creepily, kind of, it might happen. But for the average person, this girl doesn't know you. You come up on them, like, you're looking at them, like, you won't get a smile like that. But Joshua probably does, though, so I'll give him that.
Part of me was hoping we would get the chance to talk. I guess I'm not as over you as I thought. No, I guess I'm not as over you as I thought. No, I guess I'm not as over you as I thought. And I thought I was.
And he's alone. It goes right into him being alone. And we know Joshua loves his coffee shops. We know he loves his coffee. I love everything about this song, guys. You know, when it started, I'm like, oh, this is going to be a cute song. That's all that was in my head. I was like, oh, it's going to be a cute song. We could get to hear Joshua singing. But it transformed into something totally, totally different. Totally just much deeper than I originally thought it was going to be. And he did that with his lyricism. And he did that with a lot of the touches on the song. From a production standpoint, too, like that little vocal melody he did after the first chorus that wasn't in the first verse that he just threw in there, like, came out of nowhere. And then he started throwing some, like, synthy bass sounds at the end, too, but still, like, light to match the acoustic sound of the song. And then again, everything the song's about, beautiful messaging, the lyrics tying into each other. This is beautiful, and you know, you're not going to get a song like this unless you're someone like Joshua, who's willing to put themselves out there like that, and who's willing to put their heart, literally wear their heart on paper to pen. Pen to paper, heart completely on the paper, and then shared with the world. Think about that. Joshua's got a big platform, and he just shares his heart with the world in that platform, and I appreciate that so much. And this is just another example of that. I'm such a fan, and I continue to just anticipate everything he does, because everything he does is vulnerable and it's beautiful, and we live for that here. So Ashlyn remains one of my favorite albums that came out in 2021. I've also never seen an Ash music video. Ash also has a new song out. Ash is one of my favorite songwriters, one of my favorite song makers. I love her diary-like approach to songwriting. All those things put together, I can't not listen to the song, guys, and I'm just going to listen to it with you guys if you don't mind. This is Another Man's Jeans. I feel like I'm watching the beginning to, like, a old Western. Like, Quentin Tarantino is behind the lens on this film, but with the music as well. But except you've got Ash's classic live band sound. Another one of my favorite things about her is you feel like you have a live band behind you in every song that she makes. And it's such an added effect on enjoying her music that much more, and it really separates her from a lot of her pop cohorts in the music industry. She's in that pop universe, but her music is much different from your average pop star. I Wanna Soak Up the Sun? Who sings the I Wanna Soak Up the Sun? Is that Shania Twain? Wanna Soak Up the Sun? That's the first thing that pops into my head when all this happy, lucky guitar kicks in and it gets all bright.
Once upon a time, you were mine, and it made sense, and it don't make sense anymore. At times I think about when it did, when it was right. It wasn't wrong, it wasn't right very long, but it was good while it was, and it was fun, and it was sex. I don't wanna talk about the fights in your Mustang. Let's just think about the nights drinking rosé colored champagne. Is it me or is it hot? What you want is what I got. Oh, Los Angeles is fine. Let's take a drive.
Okay, I know what you mean. This is so retro. This is so like early 2000s, 90s, but like you look at cinematography and it's so today. It's so clearly there's so much effort that went into this, even from that beach shot to the umbrellas to this, and the costume design as well. Do not sleep on that. That is incredibly relevant. I love another thing about Ash. I love so much. Two things actually that the song is already very much wearing in its front is her vocal inflection, the way she's got this specific way that she sings, and the specific cadence and inflection vocally that she sings with. That does remind me of like much older classical music while having a completely new Ash spin on everything. That and the way she dances throughout verses vocally. Like Ash doesn't really give a shit about structure and about the way verses are supposed to be structured. Think about all the words that were in that first verse and how she just completely attacked them. Like she's got this way of going about verses where her choruses are always bangers. Her choruses are always bangers, and that's the interesting part about it, because her verses are always so non-like other verses, and that's exactly what I meant by she's not your average pop star. Like, she makes music very, very much in tune with what her own style is, and not like what's going to sound good on the radio. But the irony is her songs do bang on radio because of those choruses always go so hard. She's really nailed down this specific lane, and I am so here for it. This is.
I don't need a bouquet, keep the flowers. Let's go dancing. Was a time not so long ago you couldn't keep your hands off me. I know lovers like to burn. We could burn until it turns right from winter into spring. Summer starts again. Ooh, ooh,
come on, make a move if you know what I mean. You can't listen to this and not be happy.
Ooh, ooh, or I can be the girl in another man's jeans.
This is visually stunning. I've watched a lot of movies in my life, and a lot of movies that live in like the 60s and 70s, and they'll have a lot of like beachside scenes or poolside scenes with wardrobe much like this, and I really think Ash nailed it. You know, I think Ash nailed it. And like the movies I'm thinking of that have scenes somewhat like this are movies that are, one's directed by Steven Spielberg. That's the first one that jumped to mind. There's another one as well that is directed by, I want to say, is it Scorsese? I can't remember, but point is, Ash is the next Steven Spielberg.
We can have ourselves a little bit of fun. Come on, make a move if you know what I mean. Come on, let the night pull apart the seams. Or I can be the girl in another man's jeans.
What is happening? That's that sound switch up at the end. Very I don't even know what to do with that, what to make of all that. What a change. Like, that song, the song started off as a country western, musically speaking, and even the visuals, but country western starts off as a country western, turns into this Shania Twain, I Want to Suck Up the Suns. Let me make sure that that's actually who sings that song before I really disrespect the original singer of that song. Oh, it's Sheryl Crow. Okay. I'm sorry, Sheryl Crow and all your fans and family. It sounds like it goes from a country western to a Sheryl Crow song to a just Ash universe to a, I don't know, at the end there, like this completely just like techno, like horror themed outro that is just, what the fuck am I, what am I going through mentally and spiritually, and what is she going through there? She ends on the, I'm not sure what happened to her at the end there with like a suitcase maybe, I don't know. But you know, I'm not surprised in the least that Ash just pulled off a film like production, and that it goes with a song that, you know, this song is a little different from a lot of the songs on Ashlyn. It feels a bit more, I guess, upbeat. Not that she didn't have upbeat songs on that album, she certainly did, but it feels more so. While it still has elements of classic Ash, like that live band and her her vocal inflection, like the way she just attacks those verses, again, the way she does sing like she's straight from the 60s but lives in the now and stays true to the Ash way of doing things. What's interesting about Ash too is within all this music that I've heard from her so far and how all of it's so consistent, lives in the same universe, it feels like this is Ash. Like, it feels like this is who she's born to be. You know, you watch her from afar and you see that her style, like her physical style, the way she goes about life, just her aesthetic fits her music as well, and that just seems to be who she is as a human, and that's why the music is so good. If that wasn't who she was as a human, it wouldn't translate musically. So here for this. If you're late to the party, late to the channel, I reacted to Ashlyn, that album, whenever it came out. I feel like it was about a year ago. I feel like it was the earlier part of 2021. So if you look back on my channel, that reaction is there. Boy, oh boy, am I excited for this one. Sabrina Carpenter, Fast Times. If you have watched my Sabrina Carpenter reactions, particularly if you watch them chronologically and if you watch them as they've gone, I've reacted to, started with Skin, and it went all the way from there to multiple albums of hers. React 1 and 2 to Skinny Dipping, and what I want to say about her, like a bunch of live performances as well. What I want to say about her is, and I've said this before, but I'm going to say it again, she's the one. She's the next one. You think about like the next artist that is just going to explode. I mean, Sabrina Carpenter, like, that is such a easy term to use because she's already such a popular force in the music industry. When I say explode, I'm talking like my money is on her to become the next one. Think about all the pop stars, all the musicians, all the music stars that have dominated the last, you know, 10 years or so. I'm talking about that. To me, that's her. That's going to be her. This is the start. Once this next album comes out, and I know she's announced that there is an album coming, I have so much faith in her being the next one. And it makes me so excited. And again, it all started from Skin, and what a just great pop song that was, all the way to Skinny Dipping and the lyrics that are within that song. She proved to me that not only can I make a great pop song, I can also like write my ass off. So you have all those things working for you. You keep that momentum going into this song. We're going to listen to this and see what we take from this, and then the album coming out. And again, like I said, watch out for Mrs. Sabrina Carpenter. All right, this is Fast Times. Should make a movie.
Sun's up too soon, like daylight savings. Mixed emotions are congregating. Picturing us in all these places. Ahead of myself's an understatement. Sky looks sober, but I can taste it.
Ahead of myself.
Three stories up, you're contemplating, but what the fuck is peace?
Wow, did, oh my God, she just pulled that off. Okay, I was waiting to see where that, where the, what was going to happen with the chorus. I was waiting to see where that was going to go. This reminds me of one of my favorite songs ever made, ever. Not only is it one of my favorite songs, I actually think this is one of the best songs ever made. This is going to, I can't possibly pay you a bigger compliment than I'm about to pay her. It reminds me of this song. So this is a song by Frank Ocean called Pyramids. Frank Ocean is, I think, one of the greatest artists of our generation. And she just made a song to me that made me think of Frank Ocean. And not in a cheap way. And like a, not in like a, she was trying to do this way. And like a, oh wow, this actually makes me think of that. She pulled off this sound beyond what I could have ever imagined.
My feelings used to be serrated, but you speak in such a perfect cadence.
Lyrics.
Tiptoeing past so many stages, but what the fuck is patience? These are fast times and fast nights, yeah. No time for rewrites, we couldn't help it. Outlines on bedsides, yeah. Give me a second to forget I ever really meant it.
I mean, then, you know, outlines on bed, on in beds or something like the, that, that's self-explanatory, obviously, that and that, but that leads into the rest of the lyrics. How these are fast times, fast nights, we're moving really fast. I, she said earlier in the song, I get ahead of myself, and now there's the regretful part, give me a second to forget I ever really meant it. But that whole give me 1 second, it's a fast time, everything moves so fast in life. That's just like kind of how life it is, how life is. So give me this second to forget I ever really meant it. Is an embracement of mistakes also. Like, I embrace that I make mistakes and not the greatest decisions. All I can do is try and be better than that. So just give me a second to forget about that mistake. And I'm just gonna kind of live through this fast time in the regretfulness stage.
Fast times and fast nights, yeah. Closed eyes and closed blinds, we couldn't help it.
And even in the video here, she's living dangerously. She's living dangerously. And then that's very much on display, crawling through the vent and you know, obviously up to no good. If you're ever in a vent, you are never up to good. You're up to no good. And then through these lasers and this stuff, you're living very dangerously. And might I don't even, you know, I'm going to go here. There's a little Michael Jackson going on with all of this, guys.
Forget I ever really meant it. First times and first nights, yeah. Closed eyes and closed blinds, we couldn't help it. Outlines on both sides, yeah. Give me a second to forget I ever really meant it.
Is she being cheeky with
I ever really meant it.
I feel like the album's in there. The album's in there, right? The album's in the suitcase. And she's gonna pull the suitcase out at some point and be like, here you go, guys. I'm blessing you. I'm blessing you with this album. But think about, guys, what we need to do here is we need to take Skinny Dipping, Skin, and Fast Times, and think about the direction Sabrina Carpenter is going into. And just how all three of these songs are so different. Skin is this. It's got everything you want in it. It's big but sad at the same time. But like she's speaking to somebody directly. Skinny Dipping is this lyrical masterpiece. And it's got like almost this older schooled vibe, and the way she's like talking throughout much of the song, but slips back into like these very impressive vocals throughout the song, and these like light falsettos and in the chorus when she gets there, and just these beautiful, these really awesome innuendos and metaphors, and just one of my favorite songs lyrically that I can think of that's come out in recent memory. And then we have Fast Times, which is this super upbeat, like almost weekend, almost like The Weeknd. Kind of, you know, I referenced that Frank Ocean Pyramid song. It's a mix of like that and The Weeknd, and it just, it, what it really shows is like her ability to do multiple things and how you can't box her into one thing. You know, a lot of her older stuff is much more along the pop genre, and I know there's some other sounds mixed in there as well, and I enjoyed a lot of those songs too, but what I really think is that she's coming into her own as an artist and discovering like, hey, I can do a lot of different shit. And I think that her next project, I mean, if any of this is an indication, it just shows that it's going to be just that. It's going to be like all different kinds of sounds. Great lyrics, because she's officially blossomed as an artist in that way. Great vocals, because she's always got that. She's the one. Watch out for Sabrina Carpenter, because she's the one. She's the next one.